Hello everyone. Chapter 6 Pipelining and Superscalar Techniques. Contents are Introduction to Reservation Table and Latency, then Exercise Problems. Reservation Tables. The reservation table for a static linear pipeline is trivial in the sense that data flow follows a linear streamline. The reservation table for a dynamic pipeline becomes more interesting because a nonlinear pattern is followed. Given a pipeline configuration, multiple reservation tables can generate for the evaluation of different functions. Two reservation tables can be constructed for the different functions x and y respectively. Each function evaluation is specified by one reservation table. A static pipeline is specified by a single reservation table. A dynamic pipeline may be specified by more than one reservation table. Each reservation table displays the time-space flow of data through the pipeline for one function evaluation. Different functions may follow different paths on the reservation table. A number of pipeline configurations may be represented by the same reservation table. There is a many-to-many mapping between various pipeline configuration and different reservation tables. The number of columns in reservation table is called the evaluation time of a given function. Latency. The number of time units between two initiations of a pipeline is the latency between them. Latency values must be non-negative integers. A latency of k means that two initiations are separated by k clock cycles. Any attempt by two or more initiations to use the same pipeline stage at the same time will cause a collision. A collision implies resource conflicts between two initiations in the pipeline. Therefore, all collision must be avoided in scheduling a sequence of pipeline initiations. Some latencies will cause collision and some will not. Latencies that cause collision are called forbidden latencies. In a static pipeline, it is easy to partition a given function into a sequence of linearly ordered subfunctions. However, function partitioning in a dynamic pipeline becomes quite involved because the pipeline stages are interconnected with loops in addition to streamline connections. A multifunction dynamic pipeline is shown in the diagram. This pipeline has three stages. Beside the streamline connected from S1 to S2 and from S2 to S3, there is a feed forward connection from S1 to S3 and two feedback connections from S3 to S2 and S3 to S1. These feed forward and feedback connections make the scheduling of successive events into the pipeline a non-trivial task. With these connections, the output of the pipeline is not necessarily from the last stage. In fact, the following diagram shows the pattern on which one can use the same pipeline to evaluate different functions. in using the pipeline to evaluate the function x, latencies 2 and 5 are forbidden, as shown in the diagram. The ith initiation is denoted as xi in figure 6.4 with the latency 2. Initiation x1 and x2 collide in stage s2 at time 4, at time 7. These initiations collide in stage 3. Similarly, other collisions are shown at time 5, 6, 8, etc. The collision patterns for latency 5 is also shown in the diagram, where x1 and x2 are scheduled 5 clock cycles apart. Their first collision occurs at stage 6. A latency cycle is a latency sequence which repeats the same subsequence indefinitely. The figure shows latency cycle in using the pipeline to evaluate the function x without causing a collision. For example, latency cycle 1,8 represents the infinite latency sequence 1,8,1,8,1,8 and continues. This implies that successive initiations of new tasks are separated by 1 cycle and 8 cycles alternatively. The average latency of a latency cycle is obtained by dividing the sum of all latencies by the number of latencies along the cycle. The latency cycle 1,8 thus has an average latency of 1 plus 8 divided by 2, that is equal to 4.5. A constant cycle is a latency cycle which contains only one latency value. Cycles 3 and 6, as shown in figure B and C, are both constant cycles. The average latency of a constant cycle is simply the latency itself. Collision-free scheduling. When scheduling events in a nonlinear pipeline, the main objective is to obtain the shortest average latency between initiations without causing collisions. Collision vector. By examining the reservation table, one can distinguish the set of permissible latencies from the set of forbidden latencies. For a reservation table with n columns, the maximum forbidden latency is m less than or equal to n minus 1. The permissible latency p should be as small as possible. The choice is made in the range the value p between 1 to m minus 1. The permissible latency of p is equal to 1 corresponds to the ideal case. In theory, a latency of 1 can always be achieved in a static pipeline which follows a linear reservation table. Problem 1. Prove the lower bound and upper bound on the minimal average latency for the given reservation table. Solution is to prove 1. The MAL is lower bounded by the maximum number of check marks in any row of reservation table. Second one, the average latency of any greedy cycle is upper bounded by the number of 1s in the initial collision vector plus 1. This is also upper bound on MAL. From the reservation table, it can be shown that S1 has 3 check marks, S2 has 2 check marks, and S3 has 3 check marks. So lower bound on MAL is 3. Now to calculate the forbidden latency, we need to go through the check marks in the reservation table. For example, the row S1 has 3 check marks. Now find out the position of those check marks. Pairwise positions we need to consider. Now for example, in row S1, 6th and 1st position we have a check mark. So the difference is 6 minus 1, that is equal to 5. Another pair is in the position 8 and position 6 we have check mark. So 8 minus 6 is equal to 2. And one more combination, the position 8 and position 1. So 8 minus 1, difference is 7. Similarly, in row S2, we have 2 check marks in the position 4th and 2nd. So 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. And in the last row, we have 3 check marks, so 3 combination we'll get. So first pair is in the position 5th and 3rd. So the difference is 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. Similarly, we have 7th and 5th position, 7 minus 5 is equal to 2 again. And the last combination is in the position 7th and 3rd. So 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. So altogether we got the different differences like 2, 4, 5 and 7. So these are the forbidden latencies. So the left out latency are 1, 3 and 6 are permissible latencies. So from this we can obtain the collision vector wherever we have the permissible latency that need to be indicated with zeros, and forbidden latencies can be indicated with 1. So as a result, we get a collision vector like 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. To obtain the state transition diagram, we need to perform bit shift and OR operation on initial collision vector, that is CX is equal to 1, 0, 11010. Here the zeros represent the permissible latencies. So whichever position these zeros are there, that many shift, right shift operation we need to perform. Now with the initial collision vector 11010010, we have 0 in the first position. So first bit right shift operation we need to perform. So as a result, we get a pattern 01011101 after right shifting one position. That has to be ORed with the initial collision vector 10111010. So the result of OR operation is all ones. So that is shown in the first table. Second table indicates the right shift operation of the second permissible latency, that is in the third position. So 3 bit shift operation we need to perform. As a result, we do get the pattern like 0001011. Again, this has to be ORed with the initial collision vector 10110010. So resultant of that, we get 10111011. Similarly, we have one more the permissible latency, that is in the position 6th. So 6 bit right shift operation we need to perform. So as a result, we get the pattern like 0000001. That has to be ORed with the initial collision vector 10111010. The result is 10111011. From the previous step, we obtain a new state, that is 1011011, for that again bit shift and OR operation need to be performed. In that pattern, we have zeros in the position 3rd and 6th. So 3rd bit shift operation as well as 6th bit shift operation need to be performed, and finally that has to be ORed with the initial collision vector itself. So the first table shows the 3rd bit shift operation. As a result, the pattern we get is 0001011, that is ORed with initial collision vector 1011010. The result is 1011011. Similarly, 6th bit shift operation will get the pattern like 000001, and that is ORed with the initial collision vector 1011010. So the resultant is 1011011. So these resultant patterns are same as the previous pattern. So no more bit shift operation is required. Diagram shows the state transition diagram. Initially, we had initial collision vector 1011010, that is shown in the first square box. In that, the permissible latency is there in the first position. So one bit shift operation and ORing with the initial collision vector will provide a new state 1111111. So that is indicated with the arrow mark from the initial collision vector to the new state with the weight 1. Similarly, after performing the 3rd bit shift operation and ORing with the initial collision vector, we do get a new state 1011011. So that is indicated again from the arrow from the initial collision vector towards the new state. So same thing is obtained for the 6th bit operation also. Then taking the new state 1011011 upon 3rd and 6th bit shift operation and ORing with the initial collision vector, we get same state. So it is indicated using the self loop. Then for all 8 and above shift operation and ORing with the initial collision vector, it is always obtained the initial collision vector only. So that is indicated with the arrow mark towards the initial collision vector. From the state diagram, it can be seen 3, 6, 8, 1,8, 3,8 and 6,8 are the simple cycles. Among these cycles, 3 and 1,8 are the greedy cycles. So MAL is equal to lowest greedy cycle. Here it is a constant greedy cycle, that is equal to 3, because the other one is 1,8 is 1 plus 8 is equal to 9 divided by 2 will give 4.5. So that is more than 3. So the lowest greedy cycle is equal to 3. So your MAL is equal to 3. That proves the first statement. The MAL is lower bounded by the maximum number of check marks in any row of reservation table. The collision vector CX is given by 1011010. The number of 1s in the collision vector are 4. The largest average latency of any greedy cycle is 1 plus 8 divided by 2, that is equal to 4.5. So second statement is proved. The average latency of any greedy cycle is upper bounded by the number of 1s in the initial collision vector plus 1. This is also the upper bound on MAL. Problem 2. prove the lower bound and upper bound on the minimal average latency for the given reservation table. Solution is to prove 1. The MAL is lower bounded by the maximum number of check marks in any row of reservation table. Second one, the average latency of any greedy cycle is upper bounded by the number of ones in the initial collision vector plus 1. This is also upper bound on MAL. From the reservation table, it can be shown that S1 has 2 check marks, S2 has 1 and S3 has 3 check marks. So the lower bound on MAL is 3. The forbidden latencies are 2 and 4. Similarly, permissible latency are 1 and 3. So the initial collision vector is 1010. State transition diagram can be obtained by performing bit shift and OR operation on the initial collision vector 1010. So we need to perform two shift operations for the position 1 and 3. So that is shown in the table. As a result, we get a new state 1111 and 1011. For the new state which is obtained in the previous step 1011, we need to perform again bit shift and OR operation. So as a result, we get a same state 1011. So no more new states, we can stop that process. Finally, we obtained the state transition diagram with the help of those bit shift and OR operations. So that is indicated with the diagram. From the diagram, we can see 3, 5, 3, 5 and 1, 5 are the simple cycles. Among these simple cycles, 3 and 1,5 are the greedy cycles. So MAL is the lowest greedy cycle, that is equal to 3. That proves the first statement. The MAL is lower bounded by the maximum number of check marks in any row of reservation table. The initial collision vector CX is given by 1010. The number of ones in the collision vector is equal to 2. The largest average latency of any greedy cycle is 1 plus 5 divided by 2. That is also equal to 3 only. So second statement is proved. The average latency of any greedy cycle is upper bounded by the number of ones in the initial collision vector plus 1. This is also upper bound on MAL. Problem 3. Consider the following reservation table for a 4-stage pipeline with a clock cycle T is equal to 2 nanoseconds. Sub-questions: A. What are the forbidden latencies and initial collision vector? B. Draw the state transition diagram for scheduling the pipeline. C. Determine the MAL associated with the shortest greedy cycle. D. Determine the pipeline throughput corresponding to the MAL and given T. E. Determine the lower bound on MAL for this pipeline. Have you obtained the optimal latency from the above state diagram? From the reservation table, it can be shown that S1 has 2 check marks, S2 2 check marks, S3 only 1, and S4 has got 2 check marks. So lower bound on MAL is equal to 2. The forbidden latencies are 5, 2 and 1. Permissible latency is 3 and 4. So we can obtain the collision vector 10011. In the initial collision vector 10011, we have 2 zeros in the position 3 and 4. So we need to perform third bit shift operation as well as fourth bit shift operation. That has to be ORed with the initial collision vector. So as a result, we get a same state 10011 that is shown in the table. Finally, we obtained the state transition diagram with only one state. From the state transition diagram, we can see 3, 4 and 6 are the simple cycles. Among this, 3 is the greedy cycle. So MAL is equal to lowest greedy cycle, that is equal to 3. The collision vector CX is equal to 10011. In that, the number of 1s are equal to 3. So the upper bound on MAL is equal to 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. To conclude, the forbidden latencies are 5, 2 and 1. The initial collision vector is 10011. Then the transition diagram is shown in the diagram. MAL associated with the shortest greedy cycle is equal to 3. And the throughput corresponding to MAL and with respect to the given T is given by 1 by 3 is equal to 0.33 and 1 by 2 is equal to 0.5. The lower bound on MAL is actually equal to 2, but from the state diagram we obtained that is equal to 3. So optimal latency have not been found and needs a modification on the reservation table. Thank you.